Well, a very good morning to you. Happy Easter. This is how we roll here at Crate and Craft on Easter Sunday. Now, we're starting off, of course, with the fabulous Jennie Rayment. Hello, Jennie. How are you? Because it's that time of the month, yourself. Isn't it? I'm 10 days ill. I'm not infectious anymore. And anyway, it's got to get through the the bunny.
People I have appeared with in this world, but I've never appeared with somebody wearing exactly what you're wearing. Mind you, it's not often I look like this. Although my lectures, some people might remember in me.
We're wearing something else. Yes, absolutely. We'll gloss over that.
We will indeed. Yes. Come on, we've got the Quilting Classroom.
We've seen the photos.
We have indeed.
Now, it's the Quilting Classroom, of course, with fabulous Jennie Rayment, which means I don't have to do very much.
No, you don't.
Which is brilliant, especially when you're not feeling very well. So, let's go through everything that we've got for you to buy this morning. We've got some giveaways in as well, which is always nice. £9,000 worth on the show. If we sell everything on the show, then that's £9,000 worth of giveaways. Part of our £1.3 million
in their pockets.
Pounds worth of giveaways that we're giving away over Easter. So let's start right at the top here. Now, rotary cutters. You're a big fan of the rotary cutter, aren't you?
Yes, you always need a rotary cutter, and we've got several on the show. That's the big daddy. That's the one that will go through easily 16 layers of fabric, because when you retract the blade, there's a great big depth. It's a great one for cutting lots of strips, multi-cutting, thick layer, or if you just happen to have big hands, and you get the spare blade with some. You know, some of the little ones in my hands are just, I've got very large hands. You get the spare blade with it, and you get the free cutter cubby.
So the cutter cubby is the freebie there.
Right.
There we go.
So and that's great storing pencils, all sorts of things in.
£13.48 for club members. 367455. Now that's brilliant, isn't it?
That's a
great
a
way
very
to start
price.
Off. Now more rotary cutters. Now this is a small. This is a smaller one, isn't it?
This is the 45. You can see how they go down. Really, what you need is all of them.
Because so what
you
size
need
was that
this,
one?
This is 60. You need this for your thick multi layers, or perhaps for just cutting long strips and things like that, because it has a bigger blade, so it requires less effort.
Right.
This one is great for cutting. For it's the medium one. We
this
all
is the
got
one, I've
one
got.
Of those. The one you've got.
Yes.
This is sort of the average one. You start off with this, you have another one, the bigger one, and you have the smaller one. So this is a 45. We'll cut 12 layers of fabric very easily. You can just about get 16 out of push.
Wow,
also
really?
Comes with a free blade, cutter cubby, and of course there is the mat.
Cutter cubby is the freebie in this. And the mat, obviously this is a self-healing mat. And it's a big one, isn't it?
It's a big one.
It's 17 by 23 inches. There you go. So a lot of cutting there. For £32.37, it's a great value,
price.
Isn't it?
It is a good
great price.
Cutter, that and the mat and the cubby, which you can keep your pencils in, your spare tools in, your rotary cutter will fit in as well.
Excellent. 367467. Now, let's have a look at this.
Aha.
Now, these are kind of your necessities, aren't they?
They are, and they're a very useful lot of tools. This is a needle keeper. When I was younger, had a problem with needles. I left in the arm of the chair and it went through my brother's foot, and I got for that firmly chastised. Had I had one of these, I could have put my needle in here. It's magnetic. So from a safety point of view, it's very useful to have. Your needles and your pins will fit in there. Then we've got...
always leave our needles in the wrong place, don't we? It is dangerous.
So dangerous. You've got the disappearing ink pen, which is absolutely great. You can do your marking, but don't leave it too long, because when you come back, it will have gone. Clear fabric grabbers, rulers slide, put one of those on the back, one end, one on the other, and it'll stop it sliding. This is fantastic. You drop your pins on the floor. It's a telescoping magnet, okay? And it's this strong.
I like this. Right?
My husband is at the stage where he's a little more husband than I used to have.
Right.
So he's a little portly. And it would be useful for picking up your car keys. Here's good value for money. See, because if you drop your car keys or a screwdriver or something like that on the floor...
then you don't have to bend.
Then you don't have to bend. Or you put your pins down there, you can just pick them up.
Yeah, the pins, and also the pins that you can't find.
Yes.
Run around and it's going to find
it. Really useful,
that. That's excellent.
And then the freebie,
which
you get the
pins. Excellent. So all of this for £11.66. I think, yeah. 367472. I can't actually see through these glasses. I can't actually see anything.
That's
those up there.
That's good.
Right, now, acrylic bundles.
Okay, we're going to be using these today.
Okay.
Starting off with, I'm going to be doing the sandy beach using the long hexagon and...
more great names.
This is it. This is the cheating way of joining hexagons together. You need a 60 degree, so that's why they're in a bundle. So that is first of the strips on the strippy-stripy story quilt.
Okay, I have no idea what all that means,
don't
but
worry about
good.
It.
If you want to do what Jennie's going to do today, then you need to grab this. £17.99, brand new today, 367 502. Now we've got an uneven
9 patchwork. Yes. This is the waves. These are the soft waves on the seashore. But it is great for doing, as basically it makes a design with sort of like large petal shapes on it. But I'm thinking the edges of a quilt, because you could have a scalloped edge, as you will see, as I've got on the seafront. So keep watching for that, but you'll need an uneven 9 patch.
There you go, it's the names. The names always sound amazing. So if you want your uneven 9 patch, then it's £17.99, 290420 is your item number for that. And then now your 9-piece circle template set.
Right, you've got 9 different circles in quarter-inch increments. They are particularly good because you've got a very small one. They're easy to draw around. They're also marked out into eighths. So you've got quarter and indeed eighths of a circle. They fit together very nicely, and it's one of these things that it's a must-have. You're going to need circles, and if you ain't got a circle tool in your life, one of those would be very good.
Well, that's the thing, isn't it? Circles are otherwise so hard to draw.
You've never got a cup that size. You've never got a plate that size. That does the job that you want.
And quarter of an inch, we're talking seam allowances. It's going up in seam allowances, isn't it? Yep. Very handy, very well thought through. So if you want to grab that today, that's going to be £15, and I'm going to say 29 pence, yes. 367638 is your item number for that. Now, more rulers.
Right, we've got the petal pattern now. Okay. We've used the petal pattern before to make the petal pattern design, where you put 8 of these together. Let's find a bit of card. 2 of them will also make into a heart. So if you had one and you join another one there, you've got a heart shape.
Beautiful. Again, another shape
it's
that can go so horribly wrong.
It's a very useful one. And it's one that does multi-sizes. If you want to have smaller petals with arc tops, it's all marked out around the top edge.
Oh, you've got the numbers that correspond.
Yes, that correspond to those. So if you only cut a 1-inch one, you then realign your strip there with those marks and you get a shallow scallop to it.
Ever.
This is a nice deep scallop. We've had petals on before with not quite such a deep scallop, but I'm using it for the ice cream cone, as you will see.
Perfect.
Yes.
So a summer holiday theme.
Absolutely. Why not?
Excellent. Because, you know, spring equinox has been and gone, therefore.
Yep. We are now going towards summer and you'll want that for your ice cream cone.
Yes. Ah, summer. £6.29. That's great value, isn't it, for that one? 367549 is your item number for that. Now, big rulers. We need big rulers.
We do. This is, I find, a very useful ruler. It's a 4.5-inch wide ruler. There are many times you want a 4.5-inch wide ruler because 3/4 make 12. So it's one of those ideal things to begin with because you can cut out your shapes with it. They've got the seam allowance added on because it's 4.5. So from a width point of view, it's good. But it's particularly good because down here you have a spot.
What's that all
about? That's for your quarter of an inch. So you can put the line, the red line here on the edge of your fabric, pop your pencil in the slot and draw a quarter of an inch.
You know, that's really handy. Just for your dressmaking and everything.
Absolutely. That's why I like it, because, if you want to do a bigger seam allowance, then you simply measure further away and you can still put the slot in. So you're holding the work firm with the ruler. I would say it can't wobble around, and you can keep that edge perfect and then draw your seam allowance. But I like it. It's a handy size ruler. I like that effect on it, and the markings are clear, as well as it's got a 30, 45 and 60 line on it, so you can cut your shapes at your bias. At 45, you've got the 60 for triangles and the 30 for triangles. It's a very good little ruler.
This is excellent. And just £12.59. So 358166 is your item number there. God, we're rattling through them, aren't we? 45-degree triangle.
Right, this is what I'm using for parts of the quilt today. We've got the beach balls are done with that. The whole of the border is done with that as well. It's a really useful triangle because it will do a variety of different things. It also makes excellent bunting. Just think, you can cut round that shape, sew two together, you've got bunting. So we've got the 45-degree triangle.
And this
one is what is known as the flip and set. And what it's meant for, and we have demonstrated it before, is for when you put blocks on point, that's when you put them on the diagonal like that, this will measure the size of triangle that goes in between. So if you can visualise, here is a block and here is a block, and that will be the triangle. And all you do is you take the finished size of your block. So, for instance, if your block was finished 4 inches, i.e. it was 4.5 from raw edge to raw edge like that, then you would need to cut a 3.5-inch strip. From the 3.5-inch strip, you cut out triangles and they will fit between your 4-inch finished blocks on point. But I'm using it because it squares off quilts. Because I can put this on the edge of a quilt and square it off. It's great for curtain squaring off. So, you know, even if you're not a quilter and you're watching this and you're thinking, hey, come on,
I
need some
bunting. If you are a seamstress of any sort,
I need to square things off. That will do very nicely. And it fills up for easy storage.
That's what we like. 334098. That's £26.99 for all of that. Now, talking of folding up for easy storage, Jennie Rayment, we've got
this genius. I know.
Okay.
Right.
You didn't believe it, did you, when you saw it?
I saw this lying on somebody's table, and they said it fitted in their bag, and they produced a small bag, and I thought, you can't get
how?
That.
How can
bag.
That possibly fit
they said,
in a small
it folds
bag.
Up. I said, rubbish. Absolute rubbish, because, you know, I can be very disbelieving and disapproving.
And straight to the point.
And straight to the point. And there can...
You can't see it.
You can't see it. You just can't see it.
I don't know if the cameras... How close the cameras can zoom in on there, but can you see that join?
Right, I'm now going to part the ruler. Now can you see it? There it's gone.
It's magic.
It is the most amazing
it
bit
is
of
magic.
Engineering. Because it's a wiggle... It fits directly into it. Okay, it's not the cheap board. This is Prosthosby, a considered purchase, but think Easter, folks. It's a prezzy time at Easter time, and the Easter bunny might hop around and bring you one of these. You can store it. You haven't got carrying. That big mat
is
hard to carry. I've wanted one of these for a long time, and now I've got one.
You've got one. You've got that wiggle.
I can take it travelling.
Oh, perfect.
I can do what I like with it. And when I open it out, I have a decent-sized board, and it is so totally smooth.
You are paying for the magic, aren't you?
Yes, you are paying for the magic. You're paying for an extremely good, well-done piece of engineering. We turn it over. It's very firmly bound together on the back. So it's not going to come apart, and it just folds up like that, pops in your bag. You can keep it flat. You're not going to have the problem of it going wiggly because you can keep this flat.
Perfect.
You can work on your knee like that, so you can just have half a mat.
Yeah.
Or you can have a whole mat.
Because my mat that size, I have to say, storage has been a nightmare, and it's always got kinks and whatnot because it gets bent. That's perfect.
Ideal.
Absolutely perfect.
You
62.
Sewing machine. Put it underneath your sewing machine. If you're going to a class, you get it underneath your sewing machine. You need space, you can get it out, and you've got a whole size mat.
Perfect.
So, brilliant.
£62.99 for club members. We've got it on two flexies, £31.50. You know, that makes it more affordable, doesn't it? That's what we do here at Crate & Craft. We spread that payment interest-free with that flexi pay. Right, now...
You've not seen this before. This is new to me as well. This
I like
is
it.
A very special rotary cutter brought out by Fiskars. Now, there are lots of rotary cutters around on the market. And for some people, one works, and for some people, another one works. But this one has a rotating head. So you can have it like that. It's also right-handed and left-handed. You just
what do you mean by rotating head? Surely they all rotate?
No, the head, actually, the whole thing rotates. This
extends,
an extending arm, possibly. So you can use it like that. So it's very ergonomic. So it fits in the hand. It's nicely rounded, so it fits in the hand. So it requires less pressure because you're working with the weight of your body down.
Oh, directly down rather than in front. So if you haven't got the push.
You haven't got the push. That is great. And it saves a lot of possible arm ache there. But it has a little knob button on the top here, which means you can actually turn this round.
Hello.
So you go from there to there, which I find really useful because it's extending. So it's extending my arm. And I find that I can get a really good cut with this because it's extended. So if I want more of an ergonomic where I'm actually using body weight.
Yes.
Or if I want more of a jolly good push, I can push it out and extend it.
That's
and
genius.
You simply undo the blade by slotting it there and, you know, releasing it.
Fiskars right are clever, aren't they?
I've never seen this before. I thought, I really want one of those as well. So one of those and one of those. Done.
Job done. Happy Easter. £23.39. 357774 is your item number. And, of course, it wouldn't be a Jennie Rayment show without some fat quarters, would it? So we've got fat quarters here. 10% already gone. We were wondering, weren't we?
Yes,
come back,
yes,
come back.
Right.
We're coming back to look at the fat quarters.
I didn't know why you were wondering.
I was actually going to in search of my tissues. That's where I was wondering too.
And I was following you.
Yeah, well, come with me. So our fat quarters today, 100% cotton fat quarters. We always need fat quarters, don't we?
Well,
that's
this makes
the way
the quilt,
it goes.
You see.
Yes.
These six make the quilt on the wall and do the backing and do the binding and you'll have some left over. So that's why people have been following the Quilting Classroom. And they wanted to make the quilt, you see. And we ran out twice of these things. So, you know, grab them. And at that price,
well,
£36 fat quarters.
I was going to say,
£42, something rather. Less
it's
if you're
six
in the club.
Bundles, isn't it?
Yes.
Six bundles of fat quarters. Yes. Not just six fat quarters, six bundles.
36 fat
quarters. So all of these. look at this. It works out £6.45 a bundle, and it's £38.69. Genius. This is brilliant.
Just over a pound of fat quarter.
Perfect.
And it's nice fabric. And of course, Jackie, I have to admit, Jackie was doing this. She was, in fact, that one's missing a couple. She was doing a red, white, and blue thing with hexagons. So I'd rather think they might have walked in her direction. So you do get 36 folks.
Jackie will not have dabbled in your set.
No.
We promise you a full set. She's naughty, isn't she? She's very naughty. Now, okay. Bondweb. Why do we need Bondweb?
Right. Bondweb I'm using for sticking the beach balls and indeed the ice cream cones and various other things in place on my quilt. It's one of those things that, you know, if your basket is open, pop it in your basket. It's a very useful thing to have. And then finally, have we done the code for that?
We're here, 269688 for that. £2.51. Pop it in your basket. It's a bargain, isn't it?
Right. Finally, DVDs. Now, these DVDs, I'm aware you can get me on the telly, but you can't always find the programme, and sometimes husbands clear it down. This particular...
You've had that experience too. But we only save it for 7 days as well.
It's gone. Quilting Classroom, you can continue watching, but if you've bought templates or if you're new to patchwork, this is how you start doing your first sampler quilt. And the sampler quilt you can make from this particular one is hanging at the end of the studio there. It works on building on learning, so it takes you through your fabrics, how you cut, how you work the templates, and all the way through.
So this is your beginning
That's
one?
That's your beginning one. So, and there was a slight mistake in the leaflet that went with it. I have corrected that, so anyone buying them from there onwards, and I will tell you the mistake when I get to it later on, it's only a mistake on the words. The DVD is 100% correct.
Then so £22.49, but you're getting both of them, aren't you, because you're getting this and this one.
Right, this takes you through another... In fact, 7 more blocks. So the blocks on this one are the blue and white ones on the counter down the front there.
Where are they?
There they are.
There. Oh,
and
nice.
Again, it takes you through learning, because at the end of that, those two DVDs, and you've got about 4.5 to slightly more than that of me teaching you, as I do on the classroom, that will show you how to do that. And then if you want other things, and if you want to do the housekeeping...
Well, yes, so the housekeeping is both of these for £22.49. 337743 is your item number for both of those. So, of course, you get Jennie whenever you want her, whenever you need her. She's there all hours of the day and night, taking you from beginning all the way through. So the next two, Jennie.
Right, these are very different. Again, teaching, these are workshops on a disc. So if you can't get to one of my workshops, and I do teach all over the world, this is a workshop. This is a workshop, in fact, it's 2 1 days on here, taking you through the daisy design and one taking you through the lily block. Plus, this one will also cover backing a cushion, piping a cushion, putting a zip in a cushion, finishing off. The one over here takes you through 9 different blocks to, again, make up either a quilt or make up the panel that's here. Again, it is building on learning, and it is a workshop on a disc. So if you're going to come to my class, you could pay, I don't know, anything that the shop happens to charge, £60, £70, £80, £90. So that you have 3 1-day workshops for not a lot.
Well, and in the comfort of your own home, no travel, no having to lug everything with you.
And you can play it again and again, and you can pause it, and you can really stare at exactly what I've got.
And you're not going to be stuck at the back of the workshop and not able to see. So that's absolutely perfect to have. So £22.49 for that. 337744 is your item number for that. Perfect. Now I've got a sewing machine. Wouldn't be a quilting show without a sewing machine, would it? It's this thing, a Starlet 6699. It's computerised. Now, this is a great starting point for a sewing machine, isn't it, Jennie?
It is a really good place to start that. It's got all that you would need on it. It has an extension table. It obviously, you can do it. It has all the usual forwards and backwards press a foot lift. And it's a sewing machine. It's a sewing machine designed for anybody who wants to do sewing, from dressmaking, from home deck to patchwork and quilting. It comes with a patchwork and quilting foot. It has a wide range of buttonholes. It's very, very user-friendly to use. It's light, it's portable, it has a carrying handle, you can cart it round, and it works remarkably well.
And it's made by Singer, you know, so a name that we trust. So 367264, that's available on 4 flexi payments there, so you can get that home today of 78.53 for club members. So grab that. £2.99 postage. Grab
it. In your basket.
Hey, another item that you really need.
What's that?
And you're not going to know that you need it until you've got it, and then you wonder how you ever did without it. No, the Clover Mini Iron. Well, watching as well, but the Clover Mini Iron. Always great. 192527. 2 flexi payments of this of just £18, but get that Clover Mini Iron. Really handy.
It's so good for the seams. It just
keeps
them nice and flat.
Yep. Yes. It's all part of our big Easter giveaway. Is it that time?
It is.
Where I get shooed at the studio. I have to say, the very first time I did a quilting classroom, no one had warned me.
And I was like, trying to get rid of you.
I can't leave the studio. I can't. But now I know. I'll see you later. Bye.
Right. I'm sorry, folks. I'm not going to wear rabbit ears. Okay, the quilting classroom. We are going to do the last part of the block of the month quilt, which is the block of the 5 weeks quilt. This is the strippy, stripy story, as you can see it is behind me. Now, there is a PDF for it. This PDF had to get written in a terrible hurry. This last month has been extraordinarily busy. And, of course, I'd forgotten that nobody is at work on Good Friday, so it had to be in on Thursday. So there are a couple of mistakes. I will run through it. If you get this off the Create and Craft website up till probably Tuesday morning, it will have a mistake on it. I will get the new one put back on Tuesday. But if you got it off social media or anywhere else, it has been corrected there. So here are the brief words for the quilting classroom. It explains what you need and it talks you through and shows you in clarity what we're going to be doing. I'm starting off with working with the long hexagon. And this is going to make the beach part, which is the section we have here. And this is where your long hexagon comes in. Now, when it came to doing this particular thing, I wanted to use the hexagon because it sort of has being multi-sided, I thought it looked a bit like a grain of sand. What I didn't want to do was have any hassle like joining hexagons together. So I'm using the cheating way of putting a 60-degree triangle in between the hexagons, which makes it dead easy to sew together. And of course, the template that I'm using is multi-sided. So the long hexagon template works exactly the same in the same way that a regular hexagon does. It's just stretched. So if you do the basic design that's often called a grandmother's flower garden, it's just elongated and stretched. I think that the long hex makes a great border. I mean, if you put them together and you did the interfacing trick on the back, where you sew along the edges and then turn it through, think about this as an edging for something. Maybe it's a dress, perhaps it's curtains. So you could use the long hexagon for a variety of things. But if you wanted to make life a little easier and join your hexagons together with this 60-degree triangle, it does make life much, much better. And here we have bigger hexagons and 60-degree triangles in between. Of course, you could use lots of scraps up, as I have on this small piece. And here is your long hex fitted together with, in between here, I've used parts of the 60-degree triangles, literally just to sew them together. So how are we going to be using it? Let's pop these bits out the way. I'm going to be using the long hexagon to make the beach. And the beach is going to look something like this. Now, what I wanted to do was to avoid any difficulty in trying to match up the pieces. And of course, on a beach, you've got piles of sand, all uneven, so it doesn't need to be desperately accurate, does it? And of course, you could always add embellishments, like a few seashells or things like that, or buttons or beads. Or indeed, if you find a piece that goes a little wrong, you could put a beach ball or one of the other appliques on top. How are we going to make it? Well, you're going to make it by cutting out long hexagons to begin with. So I have a 2.5-inch wide strip here, and that is mistake number one in the PDF, because it actually says 3.5. So if you've got your PDF beside you, can we, where it says Sandy Beach, cut it out and change that to saying 2.5. The picture's correct. If you count the squares on the picture, it's totally correct. But sadly, well, you know, one's in a rush, more haste, less speed. So I have a 2.5-inch wide strip here. You're possibly going to want to use the pale shades, but you know, the beach colours is entirely and utterly up to you. It is your choice. Taking the long hexagon template, we're working on a 2.5-inch cut, which is why I've got a 2.5-inch strip. If you place the template on the 2.5-inch strip, it will fit exactly between the lines. Look at the arrow. Taking your rotary cutter, and you can either use the long one, as I have here, or you can use the regular one. Cut up the edge. Turn the cutter and cut along the edge so you cut the end of the shape. When you've done that, flip it round, replace the template, aligning it exactly with the lines on the template. Can you see I've got it lined up there? And cut up one side and cut along the other side. That gives you, and then when you've done, put the guard on your cutter, that gives you the shape. And basically what's going to happen is the shapes will go together in a line, and if I lay them out like this, you can see there's a little gap. Well, what fits the little gap an absolute treat is, amazingly, a 60 degree triangle will fit the gap. So from a 2.5 inch wide strip, which I had here, which I've already cut. Again, I'm using the paler shades of green because I thought on a beach, you know, sand dunes, you get a bit of green in there. But, you know, bear in mind that I'm just using colours that I happen to fancy. You could use from the pack of colours any ones you liked. Multi-cut, if you're feeling brave enough, several strips here, all put together. Take the rotary cutter, pop it on top. And we're working with a 1.5 inch wide strip. Guard off your cutter, cut up the edge. Now, you never cut towards yourself. You always turn the fabric over, replace the little triangle again, and cut away from yourselves. Please do not cut towards yourself. Hand up there and guard on the cutter. That's it. How the design is going to work is there's going to have one triangle will go in each of these spaces. One will go there, and one will go there, etc., etc. And the way you do it is very simple. Don't try to make life complicated. Take one of the triangles. It's fine, here's one I did earlier. There's one of them, there's the other one. If we take this shape and this particular piece, lay it on, remember it'd be right sides together. Now notice, when you put it on there, I'll get the barbecue skewer, it's lined up exactly on the edge here and a bit sticks out at the bottom. You're going to sew a 1/4 inch straight the way along there, exactly as we have here, 1/4 inch. You go in there and you come out where they cross over. That will be 1/4 inch. When I open it out, it extends this into a nice straight line. On the other side of the hexagon, you're going to do exactly the same thing and put another one on the opposite side. You're doing opposite corners. Pin it on and stitch it on. You might like to use two different colours, as I have here. So one on one side, one on the other side. Please do opposite corners. Don't do the same side because it won't work. When you open it out, you actually get a diamond shape. And this is where the clover mini iron is extremely useful. Mine isn't on at the moment, but just to explain, to actually open that seam and get just in the seam. Sadly, sometimes the big irons can stretch all the edges, so clover mini iron is really useful. When you have opened the seams out, you're going to end up with pieces that look a little bit like this. Now, this is the only one difficult part about this shape, is joining these two pieces together. It's lining the seam up in the middle. It's a junction that I would often call a bias seam, because when you put the two pieces together, you don't line the seam up where the seam touches on the edge. You actually line the seam up on the seam allowance. So if I open this out, the seam will be lined up where they cross over. Let's get it like that and you can see. Can we see there where they cross over? That's what you want to do. They should line up on your seam allowance. So you'll find you've got a little bit sticking out at the end and a little bit sticking out at the other end. And it's going to look something like this when you've done it. So she's talking. If I open that out, can you see there's a bit sticking out here and a bit sticking out at the other end? So it's sort of misaligned, but in the middle there, it's perfect. All right, so that's what you're after, lining up where the seam goes, not on the outside edge. I would join a whole load of them together, and I tend to go for joining them together in sets of two, and then I join the pairs together into sets of four, and I join the fours together into sets of eight, etc. To make a line big enough to go right the way across the quilt, you're probably going to need about 12 of these on one line, and I'd put about 13 in another. Because when you've done the two pieces, you're going to sew them together. Now, I considered sewing them together, so I matched up the diamond. I thought, no, that's going to be far too much difficult because I'm going to have to line the seams up. And who would find diamonds on the beach? You know, I can be a realist. So why don't I misalign them, move them down a bit? Then I can have this slightly haphazard effect and I haven't got to worry about anything matching up at all. So if you shift your two strips down a bit, put them obviously right sides together and just sew them. When you stitch them, can we please have all these little ears trimmed off? Now, I like to trim my ears off after I've done my sewing because it sometimes you need them to hang on to. And notice that I have pressed the seams open. I think you do get a better finish. Once you've sewn the two pieces together, it's going to end up something like this. But of course it'll have a funny end. Now before you do any trimming, make sure it fits the width of your quilt. It should measure 36.5 inches and indeed a little bit more. So once you've got the whole thing together, you're going to need to square off the end. So measure it and don't cut it until you've measured once, if not twice. It should measure 36.5. And be aware that these things stretch a bit. Otherwise, you'll find you'll stitch it onto your quilt and you'll have a bit hanging out the end. So when it comes to squaring it off, you just simply turn it round, take your ruler, place the ruler on the top, having perhaps drawn a line with that invisible pen, because then you can line it up. And I'm inclined to suggest you draw the line on the back, because if you've got the line in the wrong place and you didn't use the invisible disappearing pen, you will have a line somewhere you don't want a line. Simply place the ruler on the top here, cut at the designated thing and cut off. So up the edge there and cut. When you've done that, put that to one side, because we've now done the beach. So it's time for the soft waves. And the soft waves are done using the uneven nine patch. Now, the uneven nine patch is often used, and indeed the instructions that come with it. When you get your template, you'll find there'll be a little blue instruction leaflet, which will give you the instructions that go with it for actually making up this particular little quilt top. You obviously can make it bigger. The quilt top is made by taking squares constructed in the instructions that they give you of 4.5-inch squares, 4.5-inch strips, and a 2.5-inch square in the middle. You then use the tool to cut arcs out of the sides of the square. You then join the pieces together with other parts of this particular template, making this rather nice flower effect. If you wanted to square it off, you can cut half melons, which will go up the edges here. And it was looking at the half melons, I thought, I don't have to do that. I could use my half melons as a wavy edge. And then, of course, I thought, quilts. You could use this template down the edge of your quilt. So you could have a wiggly line along the edge of your quilt, like the one I've got here. And depending on how you put your colours, you could either have this being the main part of your quilt coming up to there with an edge rather like a postage stamp, or you could have this to your quilt with that for the edge. We have got the scallop template on the show, but if you wanted just a gentle scallop, it works in a 10-inch length. So your quilt needs to be either divisible by 10, or don't even worry about that, just simply cut a bit off. And if you were to cut a bit off at the corners, let's put that for the other corner. Just think, you could arrange them at the two corners there and just put a square in. So think quilt edging, think garment edging, think curtains, maybe something like that. But we're going to be using it for soft waves. So how are you going to actually do it? You'll need to cut for the wave part of the design. You'll want a 2.25-inch strip by 10.5 inches. If you take the template itself, it will say on the template that there is a line here. Place the folded line on the fold of the fabric to cut whole melons. Place line on edge of 10.5-inch strip to cut half melons. You're going to be using the half melon line. So place that on the very edge of the fabric. Make sure it's nice and straight. Take the rotary cutter and just literally cut round the edge. Now, if you find this slides, this is an ideal place to use some of these little ruler gripping things. Let's go around the edge there. Right, so when you've cut your half melon, you will need to cut the shape to insert it into. And that is done by taking a 3-inch strip by, again, 10.5 inches, and using this part of the ruler. Now, ignore the red mark on my rulers. I mark all my rulers in red these days. They don't walk quite so much. Such a nice ruler. They tend to walk. In the centre of the template, there is a little mark. If you take your 10.5 by 3-inch wide bit of fabric and you fold that in half and press it so you get a good crease, lay the melon ruler on top, lining up the centre mark with the crease in the middle of the fabric. And what you're doing now is it says place line on edge of 10.5-inch uneven nine patch block. So we're using a strip. So place it there. Little mark aligned with crease. Guard off your rotary cutter and just cut round the edge all the way around. And it cuts round an absolute treat. You will end up with the two pieces. And it's just a question now of fitting the two pieces together. What I like to do whenever I do any arced edge is to put a little notch in the very centre. So fold this over and notch the middle. Don't make too big a notch, you just need a little one. Ditto on the other half. Turn it over and make a little notch on it. There we go. Open it out. We're going to fit the two pieces together. I like to have this section on the top, so I will put notch to notch. And here's where the flower pins are very useful. Line up the notch, put your pin in. Pin head sticking out because you can remove it when you sew. Doesn't matter whether you're right-handed or left-handed. If you're left-handed, turn it round and do it the other way. Take the end of the strip, the flat end here, and bend flat end round to flat end on the shape. So that's what we're doing, flat to flat. Put a pin in it. Do exactly the same thing the other way. Bend it round, flat bit to flat bit. There. Put a pin in it to hold it. And then it really is a question of just easing it in. It just does, and by itself just literally goes quite happily all the way around there. If you want to put one pin in, two pins in, three pins in, the choice is yours. But it will just naturally fit very simply. Pop your pins in. When you've pinned it well, all you're going to do is to sew round the arced edge, and it is a quarter of an inch seam allowance. And this is where, if we come to the Singer sewing machine, this actually comes with a quarter of an inch foot. So you have in this machine a very good foot for doing exactly quarter of an inch width. From the edge of the needle to the edge of the foot, this edge is exactly a quarter of an inch. So that Singer sewing machine comes ready set up, and you're good to go with the right size seam allowance. Of course, if you wanted to, you could always move the needle to the good old position of 5.5. Once you've pinned it all the way round, all you're going to do is sew round the arc, as I did with this one I have here earlier. Move those out the way. So literally right round the arc, can you see? Using quarter of an inch seam allowance all the way round. Now, when it comes to pressing, I found it was by far the best to press it all going in one direction, from the arc onto the other side of the piece, onto the straight section. It seemed to lie flatter. Although this did give you a slight problem when you were sewing them together. But that just gave you a slightly better effect, as you can see from this one. It's got a bit turned over in the travelling. It did start off life all pressed like that. Now, you're going to need to make four of these. When you've made the four, they will simply get joined together. Now, I did notice when I've done that, because I was running out of fabric, I didn't have enough fabric to have all my C with the lines going that way. But you could have your C with the lines going this way. You could have your C any colour you like. And notice we've got this rather nice wave. So make up four and sew the four together. Just simply right sides together, join them together to make a nice long line. And you'll end up with something that looks a bit like this. Now, bear in mind, this unit is a 10-inch unit when finished. So four tens, I know, make 40. I know it's an hour earlier than it usually is, but still four tens still make 40, I think. The snag is it's going to be too long for the quilt, which is technically 36 and a half inches, raw edge to raw edge. So you'll need to cut a bit off. So I would be inclined to cut the same bit off both ends. But once more, think about it before you cut it. You know, don't just go ahead and cut it. Draw a line with a disappearing pen on the back. Measure it. Be aware it might stretch a bit. But do consider this idea for a quilt edge. I think this, I'm going to use this because I think it's going to make a really nice quilt edge, either as a gentle scallop or looking like a postage stamp. So we've dealt with the soft waves. Now, I happen to live in Emsworth. And Emsworth is a seaside town. And you'd honestly think that living in a seaside town, I'd be able to get my sailing boats right. I struggled and I struggled yesterday. I had sailing boats going every which way but backwards. I had sailing boats with hulls going the wrong way round, sailing boats with minuscule hulls in normal... You forget it, mate. To do the sailing boats, I decided that a very good template to use would be the 120-degree triangle because it's sail shape, you see? I know enough about boats to recognise a sail. This triangle can be used in a variety of ways. For instance, you could use this triangle by itself and flipped over, making a double section for doing the design I've got here. So that is this template simply cut with a piece of fabric folded and the template either flipped over or the fabric folded. And if you put three of them together, you get a 60-degree triangle. And the potential for design with this template is actually quite amazing. So you could make triangles, but you could also make rectangles, because you can take the 60-degree triangle, and here it is, I place it on there, and cut out sections and sew them together, and they make a rectangle. And you could play with the rectangle. You could make a border with the rectangle perhaps going like that. Because when you use the shape, you get a mirror image, you could also use these as a variety of different designs. I mean, think perhaps making a star. There is a star called the 55-40 fight or flight. You could do a very similar template, sorry, a similar design with that. Put a square there and you've got part of a star. These can go together to make a rectangle, and they can either go together to make a design like that, and you can play with them. So the potential for play is quite interesting. This I saw as being a sail, so I set out to make the sail. Pop those down there. And this is where things went horribly wrong. First of all, I decided that you would need to have the C, and I didn't want to have my C from one complete piece of fabric. So I sewed two strips together. I sewed a 3.5-inch strip and a 2.5-inch strip. Having sewn my fabrics together to make a long band, from the strip I cut 3-inch sections, and you'll see why in just a moment. So you will have a band of fabric stitched together, and you will need to cut 3-inch sections. You only need about 13 inches of each of the two colours, because 4 3-inch sections are all that's required, and 4 3s, strange enough, are 12. Right, so if you cut a 3-inch section, you can see on this ruler I've got the 3-inch line hard on the edge, so cut up the edge there. When you've done that, you're going to take the template and cut out, and this is where you can go wrong. So please, please, please think about it before you cut it, because otherwise it will go horribly wrong, and you'll get your sails going in the wrong direction. I cut mine out, let's get this around the right way, so that, where's my template gone to? I had the blue dotty section on my left and the red stripes on my right, and I place the template like that. And if you want your sails to all go in the same direction, you must cut all the strips exactly the same. Otherwise, you'll end up with sails going the other way. Mind you, it could be a regatta. Cut up the edge there. I'm afraid, because of the way I'm using it, that piece of fabric is now waste. So you've got one section. You'll need, from your sail piece of fabric, also a 3-inch strip. And now we can place the template on the top. So taking my 3-inch strip, place the template on the top there, aligning the 3 inches with the bottom of that. Guard off your rotary cutter, cut up the edge. To cut the second one, simply flip the template over like that, and you can cut a second sail. So just let me cut a second sail. Just get that back in the right place. There we go. I do like the fact that you can push this away from you. It's much easier with the strength. So once you've got your sails, all you're going to do is join one sail to one part, the other section. Because this fabric is reversible, it doesn't matter. You haven't got to worry about right or left, but you have got to worry about it with this. Now, when you come to sew the two sections together, this is where, watch how the layers line up. They will line up with a little bit sticking out at either end. So there'll be a bit sticking out this end, and there'll be a bit sticking out on the other end. Where they stick out should be your seam allowances. Just bend that round in the right place. And you are going to sew right the way down from top to bottom, straight through there and out the other end. And that will make, when you open it up, into a nice rectangle. You can see we sewed down there. Once you've opened it out, I seriously suggest you press the seam open and flat. So you'll need to do this 4 times. Let's get these all out the way. So you will end up with 4 sets of sails. What I did then was I separated the sails with some more C. And because I wanted the C to be a little bit different and I was using fat quarters, I sewed 3 strips together. Now, of course, you could have your C all one colour. You don't have to go to this fuss. So I sewed 3 different strips together, 1 3/4, 1 3/4, and I think it was a 2.5. Let me measure it quickly because my brain's gone suddenly that extra hour, 2.5. You will end up with a 5-inch wide strip. This I cut into 6.5-inch sections. Now, if you've got a 6.5-inch ruler, that makes life very easy. If not, you can simply use the cutting mat. So if you put the piece of fabric on the cutting mat, find the 6.5 line, pop your ruler there on the 6.5 line, and you can cut up the edge. So literally cut up the edge. And of course, if you're using the Ulfa one, you don't have to open the entire thing out. You could use just half of it. You will want to cut 4 6.5-inch sections. They will be 4 6.5 by 5 inches deep. And basically what is going to happen is you'll have a sail and some sea and a sail and some sea all the way along. When you've put them together, it's going to end up looking something, let's move this carefully, something like this. You will have a sail, move all these pieces out of the way in the time-honoured fashion, dump them on the floor, I can sort them all out later. Just hope Tash doesn't slide on them. So we've got sail, 6.5, sail, 6.5, sail, 6.5, sail, 6.5. Because I didn't want to have my boat rammed up to the edge of the quilt, I've put an additional piece of fabric on the end there, so just a bit extra strip. Leave this for a moment, don't trim it to being 36.5 inches, because we need to make the keels of the boats. And this, I'm afraid, is where the second mistake comes in. It's the positioning of the ruler. So back to the PDF. I'm sorry about this. It's just too much hassle and too, I just did it too fast. Usually I do the PDF and then I work from the PDF, so I've absolutely got it. It's this picture that is wrong. You want to have the top of the template here, not set down by 1/2 inch. So you want to have the top of the template exactly level with the edge of the fabric. It will be corrected, and I say it's correct on social media and it's correct elsewhere. So how are we going to cut them out? You've got a 2-inch wide strip for the boat keels. Taking the strip for the sea and taking different coloured hulls, I use spots and stripes. This is where you'll want the 45 degree template. And we are going to place the 45 degree template so the top of it is on the edge of the fabric, okay? Not like the picture. Have you got all that? Yes, they're all frantically scribbling it down and crossing out various bits. Top of template on edge of fabric. Cut up the edge of the ruler. Flip the fabric round. Replace the ruler, and you will need 4 boat hulls, because they've got 4 sets of sails, strangely enough. When you cut the 4 boat hulls, you'll need to cut exactly the same shape from the sea, and you'll want 5 C sections. So exactly the same shape from the sea, 5 C sections. You'll end up then by sewing them all together into a nice long line. Now, if you inadvertently use and don't read the instructions and haven't made a note of this video, you will get the wrong size for your boat keels. So you'll just have to adjust it or cut another one. Once you've done the boat keels, the way that you're going to do is stitch the boat keels to the sail section. And this is why I said don't trim it. So you can adjust your boats and sort of jiggle them along a bit so they fit. Once you're happy that they fit, simply put the 2 pieces right sides together and sew the entire thing all the way along. And you'll end up with a whole load of sailing boats all beautifully sailing on the sea, like this. And you'll say to yourself, oh yeah, but they haven't got any sails. Well, this is where the bonder web comes in. What I did to make the sails was I bonded 1.5-inch strip of a bonder web to the back of some fabric. You need to cut it out using, again, the same 120-degree template, which has now gone walkabout. There it is. But be careful, because it's got bonder web on the back, this has now got a right and a wrong side. So I did make myself a little note on the back here that cut out with the right side out, up, simply because otherwise the sails go in the wrong direction. So I've got a 1.5-inch strip here. I'm just going to trim the excess bonder web off from the sides. Always, when you're using bonder web, if you leave a little bit extra, then it just gives you a margin for error when you're pressing it with the iron. So cut it back to being 1.5 inches. When you've done that, take the strip, and I'm cutting it with the right side up. Place the 120-degree ruler on top. Guard off your cutter. Get there in the right way. And cut up the edge. This will make a sail and it will be going the right direction. If you get it wrong, you'll just have to cut another sail. When you've got bonder web on the back, you can often wriggle it and it'll come off. If not, just score it, but take the paper off. Press the sail in place. If you don't like the flat end there, give it a slight point. It's at that stage then, when you've pressed it in place, that you need to stitch it down. Now, the stitching could be done with satin stitch. It could be done with a hand applique, hand applique stitch. It could be done with a buttonhole stitch. The choice is yours. Once you put the sails on, then I suggest you check the measurement of your strip, make it exactly 36.5 inches, and cut off any excess. You'll want one final piece, which I think I probably just thrown on the floor, which I have, and this will be a 2-inch strip for the C. Again, cut that to being 36.5 inches. You will end up now with these diverse pieces. They will need to be sewn together. And you'll be sewing all three strips together to make the section that looks something like this. The beach, the waves, the sea. We'll come to the balls in just a moment. Once you've sewn them together, you'll end up with three fat strips. Now, I haven't sewn mine together as yet, but I have stitched the other pieces together. So here is the section from the first classroom, which we've got here. I've yet to put my stars on. Here is the section from the second classroom, which we've got here. And you will end up with a third section. And it's on these sections now that you can start to think about your appliques. I would tend to put the entire thing together or put the other section on the bottom, maybe add the beach, and then you can add the appliques before it gets too big. And just briefly, when it comes to talking about the appliques, I found the petal pattern template made an extremely good ice cream cone. So let me show you how I did it. This is where these circles were absolutely brilliant because they made the right size for the ice cream. So using the petal pattern template, I was able to cut out from a strip of fabric, which I'd already put some bond web on the back, the size of ice cream cone that I happened to fancy. So you can have a small cone, you can have a bigger cone, you can have a large cone. I went for that size cone, so I cut myself out a cone. I then decided it needed some ice cream. And these circles are remarkably good because you can draw around them on the back of some bonded fabric, mark the halfway section so I could get two bits of ice cream for my money, cut out your circles, and if you just cut out, say, one of them, just corner it off there because you don't want to have sharp corners on your ice cream because it might have melted, and that will make really good ice cream. And then what I found was the smallest circle was brilliant for the little cherry on the top. So this could be bonded onto your beach. Pop it down there. If I just bring this a bit nearer because I'm running out of space, but the camera won't catch it. So we've got the ice cream, we've got the cone, and you've got the cherry. When you bond it down, ice cream goes down first, cone goes down first, ice cream goes on top, and cherry on the very top. And you'd satin stitch it that, that, and that. We're going to run out of time, so I'm going to speed up a little bit. The balls, right. Balls, very briefly, are made using the 45 degree template, and it does show you on the PDF. So you will sew 45 degree pieces together, and when you've got enough stitch together, they will make a piece rather like this, and that can be cut out into a circle, again, using these circles. I don't know why it's got a flower on it. So it can be cut out with a circle. Once you've got it cut out with a circle, this can also be applied. And of course, those of you who've got fabric dyes and things could well use your fabric dye machines for other designs that I've got on here. I've scattered flowers on the municipal gardens, the grass. I've used the dye cutting from the dyes that I demonstrated sometime to make the cupcakes. And last but by no means least, just finishing off the quilt. So we'll canter through this last little section very fast because I know Tash wants to come back to clear all that lot out the way. I added one small border to the edge of my quilt, about an inch. When you come to add a border, please do not be a lopper. And a lopper is somebody who puts a strip on and then cuts it off. You will measure it, won't you? And you measure it not at the very edge, not in the middle, but in a bit. Add a strip to the quilt. And I've done that on here. All the instructions for finishing off a quilt you will find are actually on the Patchwork and Quilting DVDs. The second one has it on there. So there we go. Once you've added your border to the very edge of the quilt, what I did then was I used the 45 degree template to cut out lots of triangles. So I used the 45 degree template and cut out lots of triangles exactly as for the ball. Sewed my triangles together into sets of two, joined my sets of two together to make sets of four, went on making them. Basically, how you're going to finish it off is you're going to take the strip, Measure the sides of the quilt. Also measure the bottom. If you cut a strip for the bottom, exactly the right length for the bottom before you add the side ones on. There we go. Make the sides fit exactly. Cover it over dead straight down the edge there. One bit goes onto one side, one bit goes onto t'other side, having trimmed it off. To either end of these two pieces, you put one square one end, one square the other end over there. And then you can add that on, and that will frame your quilt. There's enough batting in the batting that we've got. As I say, if you want to know about layering and everything else, Tash will be back in a moment. But the backing of your quilt can come from all the remaining pieces that you've got. And I just literally stitched squares together. And here is the backing that I constructed with all of the squares stitched together. So from that pack of 6 by 6 fat quarters, you will have enough fabric for the quilt, the binding, the backing, and even have some left over. And should you need to know how to put your quilt together, you'll find it's actually all on this particular disc, is binding, putting the quilt together. And the last thing to tell you, if you're wondering about the mistake that was in this leaflet, is if you home in on this here, it should have said 4.5 here, 9, 9, 18. So there we go. And all the new ones that come out from day onwards will be corrected. So I think that's about it, our Tash.
Hey, Jenny.
We'll find
good
something
job.
To give them. Yes.
Oh, my goodness. What's happened down here?
I swept stuff off the counter. You'll have to pay.
Come chance.
Thank you. Thank you. Right. OK, something, I'm not quite certain which, we'll go to. But
let's have a little
look,
shall we? Good show today, Jenny.
Thank
enjoyed
you.
It. Christine Sampson in West Yorkshire, congratulations.
You'll get something.
I don't know what. Well, have a rummage and see them. I mean, there's
we'll
lots on
the floor.
Hey, you need your magnetic-y thing. You've got pins on the floor and everything. Jenny, thank you so much.
Thank
when
you.
Are you back?
Back on April the 13th.
Excellent.
And next Quilting Classroom, May the 1st.
Fantastic. There we go. Nigel's up next to you, Jeannie's. Have a lovely